Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I am going to explain you IPv4 broadcasting. In my previous videos also, I have explained you how broadcasting happens. But here there are few essential concepts that I would like to explain. That's why I have made separate video based on IPv4 broadcasting. See, there are basically two types of broadcasting. One is directed broadcast and second is limited broadcast. When it comes to limited broadcast, let me explain you what is the meaning of it. See, in limited broadcast, any of this host can broadcast message in this network. Any of this host can broadcast message in this network. Any of these two hosts can broadcast message in this network. So that is limited broadcast. When it comes to directed broadcast, or you can say direct broadcast, in that, see, in this network, any other host can do broadcasting. In this network, any other host can do broadcasting. So that is direct broadcast, right? Now, how it happens? Let us try to understand that. So first, when it comes to limited broadcast, as I have told you, for this given network, any of this host can do broadcast. Now, how it will happen? Let us consider host 1 wants to do broadcast in this given network. Then what host 1 will do? Host 1 will use destination IP as 255.255.255.255. So in given frame, let us say here we are having one frame, and as if host 1 forwards frame with destination address as per 255.255.255.255, then this frame that will get broadcasted by router 1 in this network. Now, how router 1 will broadcast this? See, router 1 is intelligent device. It will see first incoming frame from host 1 over here. And once that frame is having destination IP, that is this, router 1 will get to know like, okay, this frame belongs to broadcast in this given network. So what router 1 will do? Router 1 will broadcast this frame with the use of data link layer. Let me explain you how. See, whenever you form frame, at that time, at network layer, we add IP address. At data link layer, we add MAC address. And here, we are talking about same network. So for same network communication, you don't need to have IP address. You can have MAC address only for communication, right? For same network communication, you can communicate by MAC address. You don't need to have IP address. IP address requires for other network communication, right? So once that frame comes from H1 to router, router will see what is the destination IP. It will see destination IP that belongs to broadcast in this network. So router 1 will use data link layer in which it will forward that frame with destination MAC address as per all apps you see. Means MAC address is 12-digit hexadecimal number, right? All F means what? All binary bits 1, right? So destination MAC, that is FFFFFFFFFF, by which this router will forward signal. And as this router forwards this signal as per this destination MAC, it is getting broadcasted in this network only. It will not get broadcasted over here. Now you might be thinking like, how it is not getting broadcasted over here? It is not getting broadcasted. The reason is, see, router to router communication that happens via IP address, that cannot be done with the use of MAC address, right? So when router 1 forwards this same frame with destination MAC as all F, at that time it is getting broadcasted over here only. It will not get broadcasted over here, right? The reason is router to router communication that happens with the use of IP address at network layer. So here it will not get broadcasted. See, practically that is how it is happening. So when it comes to broadcasting, practically in computer network, at that time, real magic that happens at data link layer. Even though we forward frame with the use of IP address, but broadcasting practically done by router with the use of MAC address, right? At that time, it will make this destination MAC as all apps, and then that is getting broadcasted. Right. Now let me explain you how things are happening with directed broadcast. So in directed broadcast, see, any host can broadcast message in other network,
right?
So here for that directed broadcast, let me take one example. Let us say we are having this network, and this network is having network IP, that is this. So let me note it down. First I'll explain you what is the meaning of this IP. So this network, right, that is having IP, that is 112.152.12.0/24. So see, this is the IP which is there with this network. Now let us say host 4 wants to do broadcast in this network, then how it will happen? So first of all, you need to understand what is the meaning of this IP. See here, /24, that is written. /24 means mask size, that is 24 bits. Mask size, that is 24 bits. So what is that 24 bits mask size? You see, IP address that is having this first octave, that is of 8 bits, then second octave that is having 8 bits, and third octave that is having 8 bits. So in total 24 bits, this is the mask size, right? And last octave, that is 0, which indicates this is what network IP, this is what network IP of, this is what network IP of this network, right? So first of all, you need to understand this /24 means this is size of mask. So this is what size of mask over here, right? So here now, how this H4 can broadcast in this network which is having network IP, that is this. So here, see, this mask that should be as it is, this mask data that should be as it is. So here what this H4 will do is, H4 will transmit a frame, and in this frame it will keep destination IP. It will keep destination IP as per this mask will be as it is. So 112.152.12. Remember, mask will be as it is. And the bits which are other than mask, that should be all ones. So 8 bits, all ones means 255. So .255/24. See, this is what destination IP, which is there with this frame, which will be given to router, which will be given to router 3 by H4. So this frame now that will be routed to router 2 over here, and router 2 will receive this frame as per, see, last 8 bits as 255. So as last 8 bits as 255 is received by router 2, router 2 will broadcast this message over here with all the host, right? But how it will happen? See, router 2 knows this destination IP that belongs to limited broadcast, right? But practically, with the use of data link layer, router 2 will broadcast it. You see how in data link layer, what it does is it will keep this frame's MAC address as all F, as it was done in limited broadcast, right? Once it receives this frame with this destination IP, it will provide all F in destination MAC address, and based on that it will do broadcast. So this broadcast signal that will not go over here, right? It will not go over here. It is getting broadcasted here only. The reason is router to router communication that happens via network layer, while in same network communication we can have communication with the use of MAC address. So practically, broadcasting that is happening at data link layer, right? But forwarding of frame, that happens with the use of IP address, right? So this is how things are happening. Now I think probably you are having fair enough idea about how broadcasting is happening. Still, if anything that you would like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.